Welcome to the in-depth Before You Buy for Triggerfish. We did do the first look video, which showcased gameplay, the bubble flage in game as well, and him without his back bling, how the back bling is actually reactive, the Coral Commandos. So with that being said, let's get some combos and let's get sweaty. Back blings for Triggerfish, starting with Altitude, the Assassin Pack. I'm going to try my hardest to not say tactical a ton of times, guys. I do apologize. Yes, I'm kind of fanboying over this outfit because my role in the military was an infantryman, which is essentially a boost on the ground, tip of the spear, front lines, soldier, or you call us grunts, whatever you want to call us. So this one does have a little bit of meaning to me personally, as I can totally relate to the night vision goggles, the helmet, the war belt, the plate carriers. Like, it's really cool, the combat boots. They're a little tall, I will say that, but very well done, very cool. In terms of the face paint, the only time I actually used face paint in the military was during my stalks in sniper school. Other than that, I never painted my face on my deployment. Now, I can't speak for special operations. I don't know what they do out there, but it's really not super realistic on the face paint. But I mean, the rest of the outfit is very cool. It's a fun skin. Really happy about it. I didn't know it was going to look this good. I didn't know that it had the edit style for the combat helmet either. I had no idea. Very surprised by this. I'm having a really good time right now showcasing this. A lot of these backlings are somewhat military related or like backpack related. In terms of the banner shield and cape, I used an orange to go with his actual skin color, as the rest of the outfit is just like a military green and some light beige tan. So I think the orange makes the outfit pop really well with his skin tone. The barrel and booty looks really good as well. It is C related. The buzzy bag, the road ready back bling, pair of provisions, grande pack looks really cool. Detonator doesn't look bad. This one's all right. Color seems okay. So this is what it came with. The Coral Commandos, like I told you, within the first look video I already uploaded right before this, I showcased what it actually does in game and how it is actually reactive. Very cool there. The saltwater satchel, fish sticks, original back bling, shrimpy, signal hub, signal jammer, spectral spine to go with the blue scarf, Tana back bling, vintage aka the Jansport back bling, trail tote looks pretty good. The tackle box, really cool. Both color schemes look really good to me. I like the yellow, but I also like the default because it does have that military green. Slash back bling, can't go wrong. The buckled back bling, very cool as well. And then the tri-pack. So I'm actually gonna go for my favorite one here is the banner shield, because I really like how it bounces off of his skin tone. Very cool there. Now, I don't want to be a Debbie Downer, but this back bling, in my opinion, in terms of reactive, the idea, very cool. In terms of, do I want to see it on my back? Absolutely not. I do not. I don't like the back bling, but I love the idea of the song playing from the Coral Cruiser Glider. And they also have little camouflage bandanas, the same bubblegum pattern around these specimens, these underwater creatures. So that is very cool, kind of cute, just not my type of back bling whatsoever. But the reactive part is very cool. I will give it that. Very, very cool. So I really didn't know what to go for here. I didn't know what to go for here because I don't. I guess like color scheme was kind of weird for me. I wasn't really sure what I would want to put it on. So in terms of like a storyline or does it make sense? I picked out like the divers, the deep sea divers, the scuba divers, other fishing related outfits. Like, I mean, surf rider, does it really? It looks pretty good on her. The brat, it kind of weird. This is what it came with, obviously. I'll show you his edit styles in case you have not seen the first look, which you should definitely check out. So he's got no face paint with the face paint. And then he has the face paint with his helmet on. And his nods are offset because his eyes are that wide. So yes, it is accurate. Although the clip on the nods, the cap kind of bugs me. That would really get annoying on a mission and jangling around. So if that was gone, it'd be a little more accurate. But this is a video game. I'm not going to roast the details there. Okay? But yeah, it's very cool. Ooh, it looks really good on her. Again, another water-related outfit. Kind of weird on the color scheme. Turk versus Riptide. Again, he's a fisherman. It just makes sense to me. I don't know how you guys feel about it. I don't know how you feel about this back bling. It's kind of cool. The idea is great. Just not really for me. If I had to pick one that I thought it looked really good on, actually, Mary Marauder. Surprisingly, is probably one of the best ones, in my opinion, right now. Harvesting tools you could use with Triggerfish, not necessarily need to, but just giving you some ideas of what you could use with Triggerfish, starting with Chom Jr. It matches the idea, like the background of the outfit. Razor Edge to go with his orange skin tone. His fish tone, skin tone, scale tone? Scale tone, perhaps. The turbine, it's like an airplane engine. Military vibes, though. I would say it goes well with his camouflage that he's wearing. Also, the Raptor glider I showcased, it goes really well with his color scheme, like the bubble flage. It goes like hand in hand. There's a better representation. Really cool. Now we have the fresh cut. Very, very basic axe. It almost looks like it has, in a sense, 550 cord, if you guys would know what that is. It's very common in the military to tie things down. Very strong as well. The icebreaker. It's a shovel. I like using this with my military outfits within the game. Very cool to me. I don't know how you guys feel about that. And then the tactical spade. I showcased this in my first look. It looks like an e-tool that I had on my rucksack, you know, that I used to dig foxholes. Excuse me. Foxholes with. Foxholes? Foxholes. So there's some really, really cool harvesting tools with Triggerfish. Triggerfish, is he a rare rarity? I believe he is. Do we like the color scheme? It's just military camouflage, the bubble flage weapon wrap, same kind with some tans. I think it's all right. And then the blue scarf kind of gives it a little bit more, and also the blue bandana. Two out of two there. Does it match a decent amount? I think the outfit does. I don't really care for the back bling, the Coral Commando, too much. So I'll give it a one out of two there. Do we think the outfit is creative? I think I'm being biased here because I do have a military background. I've been waiting for something like this for so long. Did I imagine it was going to be Fishstick, the one that was wearing it? Absolutely not. But I do think it is very creative, 2 out of 2. And will I use it? Yes, I will. It's probably within my top 10 now. So 9 out of 10 for Triggerfish. Yoink. And with that being said, guys, liking the video is always appreciated. Subscribing is free. Hopefully you guys check out the first look video if you guys didn't miss it. And with that being said, we'll see you nerds on the live stream. See ya!